Hi, everyone. My name is Sri. So I'm an employee at Grab, as you can see by the badge. So I've been with Grab for nearly 2.5 years now. And most of what I used to do was build web stuff at Grab, right? So this talk is primarily going to be about how we do stage rollout or percentage rollout for SPAs at Grab. Cool. So if any of you have shipped any code at all, I think this is something that you're quite familiar with. Deployment without catastrophic failure is almost impossible, right? So whenever there's new code that goes, stuff does go wrong. And what's worse than stuff going wrong is stuff goes wrong and it affects everyone that's using your product. Right. So what's wrong with affecting everyone? You have this amazingly architect backend, which, you know, runs on queues. You have SQL versus NoSQL debates that you've had for years. You have your Redis, you have your machine learning models, et cetera, and then you have your JavaScript fail, and this button doesn't click, and then everything that's in the backend doesn't matter anymore. Right, so if your UI is broken, then the user is not going to care about what your product is. So how do we solve this? Right, so the solution for this has existed for decades in the backend community, and but it's not so commonly used in front end. So when we try to bring this to the front end or statically hosted web apps, the problem statement becomes something like, you know, you want to be able to deploy two or more bundles or statically hosted assets, and you want to specify a percentage which kind of affects or controls what distribution of each asset goes to the end users, right? And of course, you have a feedback loop. So you have monitoring and alerting. So if something goes wrong, you know right at the beginning and you can control your blast radius. Cool. So let's start with what we know. So how do we do this for backend and why is it so easy? So typically backend or services, microservices run on multiple instances which have the same code. So when you want to deploy new code, you pick one or a percentage of your fleet and you push your new code to that. And if it works fine, you gradually increase the percentage based on the feedback that you get from your metrics and alerting. Cool, so that works. Why can't we do this for web apps? So the thing about web apps is that you have this tree-like dependency structure that happens when you load a website. So typically, the first request to your website would load maybe your HTML, let's say your index or HTML, and then that triggers off multiple requests. So it would, you load JavaScript, you load CSS, you load images, other assets, and then now with, you know, your dynamic requires, your JavaScript can further load more content. So what's the problem with that? So with how web apps are bundled, typically to make use of long-term caching, you have these hash prefixes, right? So you have certain assets which are cached, certain assets which you don't want cached. So stuff like your index or HTML, you don't want cache. But things like JavaScript, you may want to cache for a while as long as the content doesn't change. So let's say you have two bundles, right? Both of them have an index or HTML, but then your main bundle requires, let's say, app.1a.js, but your experiment bundle requires app.2b.js, right? So if your index or HTML was loaded from the main bundle, then all subsequent requests have to go to the same bundle or the same place that this bundle is hosted, right? So this requires a certain level of stickiness of all subsequent requests. Apart from that, we want to also give a good user experience. So we don't want we don't want, let's say the user get the experiment version or the new version of your website, and then he closes the browser or he refreshes the page and he gets pushed back to the old version. That's not a really good UX, right? And apart from that, we want to also make use of the good stuff for the web, which is not too much of a concern for backend services. Stuff like, you know, you have your browser level caching of assets, you have like service worker caching, you have CDN caching. So things like this you still want to make use of. You want your website to load quickly. You don't want requests taking forever to figure out if, you know, this user should be serve the main bundle or the experiment bundle, which means you need to use stuff like CDN. And typically your websites themselves might be hosted on not instances but rather serverless environments like S3 or object storage. So the landscape of the hosting of websites is significantly different from backend services. So how do we make gradual rollouts or percentage rollout work in this case? Cool. So what do we need to make this work? So first of all, we need a permanent identifier that is sent with every request that comes to the server. And browsers give a very elegant way to do this using cookies, right? So every request that comes from the browser has cookies if they were set prior to this. So maybe we can make use of this to somehow hint to the server whether we should, we should return the main bundle or the experiment bundle. And if it's the first request from the user, then there's no cookie. We just, flip a coin and decide whether to give him the main bundle or the experiment bundle, and let's set the cookie. Cool. So let's tackle a smaller problem first. Instead of a dynamic percentage rollout, let's assume that I want to solve a static problem first. Let's assume that I want a rollout factor of 40%, and that will never change in the future. So I want 40% of my users to always be on the experiment bundle and 60% of my users to be on the main bundle. So how can we solve this? Right, so let's assume that we have a user that's visiting our website for the very first time. So his initial request, let's say it is to index.html, will come without a cookie. So the web server, web app server will flip a coin and decide whether to return to him the main bundle or the experiment bundle. So let's assume that it's decided to return the experiment bundle. So what it does is it returns the asset itself, which is the index.html, but the experiment version of it. And it also sets a cookie. Let's assume the name is just bundle, and the value of the cookie is experiment. So from that index.html, all triggered subsequent requests will come with this cookie, right? So then the web server just looks for the cookie. So it sees the bundle is experiment, and it knows which location to look for to return these assets. So all subsequent requests from the user, so let's say he closes the browser or he refreshes the browser, the cookie still persists. So all subsequent requests will come with the same cookie, so the user does not toggle back and forth between the main the experiment version of your website and the main version of your website. Cool. So a small demo over here. So this is just a basic Create React App website. So I've set a cookie on the request, first request. So when I clear the cookie and reload, I could get a different result based on what the web server did, what the result of the random number generation was. And if you see the network requests, so the first request was for the main bundle and the subsequent request was for the experiment bundle. And you see the content, even though the first response is the index.html, all the subsequent assets that are loaded are totally different based on which bundle was returned for the index.html. And all subsequent requests that have the experiment cookie, all subsequent requests will carry this cookie, and therefore the same version of the website is returned to me. Cool. So this works very well for a static percentage factor, but that's not what we want to do. We want to ideally increase this rollout factor and try to push our experiment bundle to 100% of our end users. How do we do this, right? The problem with setting a static string with like main and experiment onto the browser of your end user is that you lose control of that. It's not easy to change that anymore. Let's say I want to increase my percentage factor to 60%, then I need to invalidate all the previous cookies that I've set, and I need to rebalance essentially the percentage of the main cookie and the experiment cookie that goes, right? So this is not really elegant or easy to do. So let's try to solve this in a slightly different way. So the larger problem statement is very similar to the previous one. We still have two bundles, the main bundle and the experiment bundle. And we want to serve these two clients randomly based on our percentage weight. But we want the ability to be able to increase and decrease this rollout factor dynamically and affect the percentage of users who are being served the respective bundle. Cool, so how do we do this? So instead of setting a cookie with a string which represents which bundle, we instead set a cookie with a number. So this number ranges, let's say, from 1 to 100, and it represents which bucket the user is in, right? So you can think of it as splitting your user base into 100 buckets, and you assign a bucket to each one of your users. Assign a user to one of these buckets, right? So the first request that comes in from the user, so let's say he's never visited your website before, the first request to index.html. So what your web server does is it generates a random number between 1 to 100 and assigns this number to the user, which is set as a cookie. And let's assume that your current rollout factor is 5%. So it compares this bucket number with the 5%, which is your rollout factor. If it's less than the rollout factor, then it will return the experiment bundle. If it's greater than the rollout factor, it will return the main bundle. So in this case, the random number generated was 10, which is greater than 5. So it returns your main bundle. And all subsequent requests come with exactly the same number from your client's browser, which is compared to the current rollout factor and returns the assets as decided by that. Let's assume you increase your rollout factor to 20% now, and this is something you do in the backend. You don't really, your client is not affected in any way. Your subsequent request from the same user still has the rollout bucket as 10, but now when your web server compares this 10 against 20, 10 is less than 20, so it chooses to return the experiment bundle to the user. Cool, so let's see how this works. So so this is the first time the user visits the website. He's been assigned into a bucket of 83. All subsequent requests that go get the same number, but if you clear the cookie and request, a different number is given to him each time. And for this demo, I set the factor as 40%. So when a number was generated that's less than 40, he gets the experiment bundle. And as seen previously, is the same thing. So you have different different assets that are returned, different bundles that return. And every subsequent request for the same website goes with the same cookie. And if you don't change your rollout factor, will return the same bundle. Cool. So this is a bit more. Yeah, so let's assume that you have three users over here. So this user falls into a bucket of 11, the other user falls into a bucket of 50, and the other user 100. So I've used Lambda at Edge with CloudFront to simulate or to configure how the CDN kind of figures out the logic of what's the rollout percentage. So basically, I'm increasing the rollout percentage to, I believe, 20 or something over here. So once that's deployed, I go back. I think I increased it to 50, if I'm not mistaken. So this user will still get the experiment bundle. I think it takes some time for the Lambda at chains to reflect. But typically, the second user, since his bucket now falls less than the rollout factor, is also returned the experiment bundle. And but the third user, whose bucket is greater than the rollout factor, is not affected at all. So he still gets the main bundle. I think finally, if you do a full rollout, which is essentially setting your rollout factor to 100. Yeah, so once you've changed your backend and set the rollout factor to 100, typically refreshing the final, the third user who sits in the bucket of 100 would also return the experiment bundle. It takes a few refreshes because the backend, the Lambda deploy takes a bit of time. So once you've increased the rollout factor, as long as you don't change what's the cookie value that's set in the user, he'll always get the same version of your website. That's cool. So deploying this in a serverless plus CDN kind of environment was a bit challenging. What we used is CloudFront with a bunch of Lambda at Edge. So basically, what Lambda Edge does is it gives some intelligence to your CloudFront. So you can have small snippets of code that does things like, you know, compare the cookie value with the rollout percentage to figure out whether you want to return the main bundle or the experiment bundle. And then we decided to separate out the main bundle and experiment bundle into two different S3 buckets just for, you know, ease of deploy and, you know, you don't trip over file names and things like that. So then we needed a separate Lambda to figure out which S3 to fetch the bundle from. And then we have a viewer response Lambda. So basically, you can configure these Lambdas at different life cycles of the request. So basically, we've configured the viewer response Lambda to set the cookie when the request goes back to the client or the browser. So if any of you have any questions on how exactly this, because I know that it's not very easy looking at this diagram and figure out what's going on here. So feel free to come back to me. I can help explain this further, and I can share, what is the code that actually sits in these Lambdas that makes this work. Yep, that's about it. Thanks for listening to me. Any questions, feel free to reach out. Thank you.